Hello children, let us continue with lesson 1. Today we are going to see the graphical representation of motion. Now what is graphical representation of motion? Graphical representation makes it simpler for us to understand data. When analyzing motion, graphs representing values of various parameters of motion make it simpler to solve problems. So let us understand the concept of motion and the other things related to it using the graphical method. Now children, as you can see here, we are going to plot a graph of distance versus time. The distance time graph determines the change in the position of the object. The speed of the object as well can be determined using the line graph. Here the time is taken along the x-axis, which is in seconds, and the distance is taken along the y-axis now let us see the time intervals. You can see it's almost a table of 10 0 10 20 30 40 50 60 and 70. So each time when you take the difference between the readings, it is going to be 10 each. It is going to be 10. 70 minus 60, 60 minus 50. And here also you can see it's the table of 15. So when time is 10 seconds, your distance is 15. When time is 20 seconds, distance is 30. When time is 30 seconds, the distance is 45. And when time is 70, the distance is 105. So when you take the difference at every step, we get a difference of 15. We get a difference of 15 units. Now here distance is given in meters and distance is taken along the y-axis, whereas time is given in seconds and time is taken along the x-axis. Now when we are plotting, so in between 0 and 20 along the y-axis, the centermost reading is going to be 15, correct? Then between 20 and 40, we can plot 30. Between 40 and 60, we can plot 50, and so on and so on. Now after plotting the points if my time is taken as 10 seconds, distance is taken as 15. If time is 10 seconds, distance is taken as 15. When time is 20 seconds, distance is taken as 30. In a similar way, we are going to plot all the points. And after plotting the points, when we join these points, we get a straight line graph. So, the nature of the distance time graph for a uniform motion. Now, who is performing uniform motion here? It is the car who is performing uniform motion. So the distance covered by the car in fixed time intervals is also uniform, is also equal. Now, nature of the distance time graph for uniform motion, once we join the points, how does the graph look like? That is the meaning of nature. So the nature of distance time graph for a uniform motion, the graph is a straight line. As you can see, when we join these points that you have learned in maths, how to join the points, we get a straight line graph. Now, how do we determine the slope of the graph? Now, slope of the graph is given by the formula y coordinate by x coordinate. Now, for example, just let us consider two points and let us see whether we get the slope as same. Now here you can see children, here if the distance is 15, so the y coordinate is 45. If you take the distance as 45 and if you take the time as 30 and if you take the time as 30, the corresponding time as 30. So this can be written as 15 into 3. So, we are left with 3 by 2. So, the slope is 1.5. let us take one more reading in order to find out slope. So let us take one corresponding reading. Let us take 60/40. So when distance is 60, the y coordinate, when distance is 60, the time taken along the x axis, the x coordinate is 40. So you can see we get 60/40, cancel the zeros, we get 6/4. So if you cancel by 2, you get 3/2. Here also you can see we are getting the same slope. Children, slope. Now you must have understood what is slope. How do we determine slope graphically? Graphically, slope is determined by y coordinate by x coordinate. And I have shown you two cases here. When your distance is 45 meters, the corresponding time is 30 seconds. Correct? So this is meters and this is second. So your answer is 1.5 meters per second. And when your distance is 60, from the chart, when your distance is 60, you're taking time as 40. Distance is on the y-axis and time is along the x-axis. So when you take the slope, y-coordinate upon x-coordinate, you cancel the zeros, you get the answer again, same, that is 1.5. So 60 meters and 40 seconds. So again, you get meters per second. And as we know, meters per second is the unit of speed. Meters per second is a unit of speed. So coming back to this, slope is equal to y coordinate by x coordinate. I've shown you two examples, children. Y coordinate by x coordinate. And here also y coordinate by x coordinate. So y coordinate, along the y axis we have taken distance, and along the x axis we have taken time. And what is distance upon time? Distance upon time we define as speed. So the slope, of distance time graph, indicates the speed of the car. The slope of distance time graph for a uniform motion will help us to calculate the speed of the car. Correct? And the nature of the graph is a straight line. Whenever we have uniform motion, we get the nature of the graph as a straight line. Now children, on y-axis we have taken 1 centimeter as 20 meters. And on the x-axis we have taken 1 centimeter as 10. As per your ease, or as per, children, see, if the readings are 15, 30, you can also take it as 0, 15, 30, and so on, whatever is convenient to you. According to that, and depending on the size of the graph paper also, you will decide this scale. No matter whatever scale you take, children, if it is an example of uniform motion, you will always get a straight line. Irrespective of whatever scale you take. Now, the next graph. Is to show the distance time graph for non-uniform motion. As you can see, distance is taken along the y-axis and time is taken along the x-axis. Children, look here. Now, why do we say it is a non-uniform motion? Here you can see the time intervals. The time intervals are same. There is a gap of 5 seconds. But when we look at the distance, when you subtract, you will come to know the distance covered is not uniform. 58 minus 50 gives you 8. 50 minus 41 gives you 9. Then 41 minus 30 gives you 11. 30 minus 20 gives you 10, 20 minus 12 gives you 8, 12 minus 7 gives you 5, and 7 minus 0 gives you 7. So you can see the distances that are covered are not equal. So we say it is a non-uniform motion. Now, what kind of graph do you expect for a non-uniform motion? Definitely, we are not going to get a straight line here. In this case, we are not going to get a straight line. Then how do we see the nature? If you are asked to say the nature of the graph, how will you say? We will say that the nature of the distance time graph for a non-uniform motion will give you a curve. Correct, children? So when your time is 5, Your distance plotted here is 7, correct? When your time here is 10, the distance plotted by you is 12. When your time here is 15, the distance plotted by you is 20. When your time here is 20 seconds, the distance plotted by you is 30, correct? When your time taken is 25, there distance traveled you have taken as 41, slightly above 40. And when your time is 35, when your time is 35 seconds, correct? In that much time, you can see distance covered is 58. Now again, the same thing, children. Scale, it is totally depend on you. Whatever is easy for you, according to that, you can take the scale. Now, this is also a graph of distance covered by bus in equal time intervals. This graph represents the distance covered by bus in equal time intervals. Correct, children? Now, since in place of a straight line, we are getting a curve. We are getting a curve. So, this graph does not show direct proportionality between distance and time. Between distance and time. Is it clear, children? So, the nature of distance-time graph for uniform motion is a straight line. Whereas, the nature of distance-time graph for a non-uniform motion, you are getting a curve. You are getting a curve. So, this graph does not show a direct proportionality between distance and time. Between distance and time. So, we are not taking even the slope of it. So, we are not even taking the slope of it. I hope it is clear. Okay.